Today, I'm going to show you guys how to get into and maneuver through the Tumble Books website. And as far as I know, this is a newer website for us to access. And this is going to be a great, great resource to give you guys options on books to read at home. So once you've logged into Clever, you're going to scroll down to the digital resources section. And then you're going to choose the Tumble Books icon, which is this green circle with a blue book doing a cartwheel through the center. When you click on it, it should log you in immediately. So you shouldn't have to go through any sign-in. If you do get a sign-in page, the username is Melville SD for Melville School District, Melville SD, all lowercase. And then the password is books, BOOKS. If you have any trouble logging in, just give me an email, send me an email, and I'll help you as best I can. What I want you guys to know here, from what I've discovered in playing around, is that you have a couple options in the types of books that you'll be able to access, and we're going to talk about that in the next video. But right now, I just want to show you how to maneuver through the website. There's a tab here at the top for storybooks. So these are your picture books, and they're broken down into various categories as you scroll along the page. There is a tab for read-along. So these are all types of books. You can see early readers, chapter books, advanced readers, but these are books that will be read to you. So it's like an audiobook, but it's all online. The e-books are books that are a little bit longer than the picture books. So they might be early chapter books all the way through more advanced, but these are books that you will read on your own. They do not have an audio component to it. There are graphic novels, nonfiction, and then there's a section for videos from the National Geographic. So if you're looking for some nonfiction information, this would be a good source for you. Okay. There are playlists that break down books that are under a certain amount of time. And then they have some other special categories as well. Okay. And then there are puzzles and games if you are interested in that. So far, what I've been able to do is mark some books as favorites. So you'll see that when you click on a title, they sometimes give you the option to add it to your favorites, or sometimes they'll have favorites and their playlists. And these are ways to mark a book that you are interested in reading later. So a playlist might be books that you know you want to read in a certain order, or favorites could just be books that you're currently reading. However you want to use those categories is fine. But once you click on that icon, if you come to the very top of your screen, when you click favorites, you should have those books listed under that section. Same thing for playlist. If you click it that you want it to be in your playlist, then it will play one after the other. So especially if you're doing picture books, this is a good way to have a series of books lined up that you're interested in that you're interested in listening to and reading. Okay, and then of course, if you want to go home, you can navigate in this breadcrumb trail right here, or you can click on the home at the very top of your screen. So I hope that helps you guys get started. The next video is going to show you guys how to actually use the Tumble books themselves. And there's two different formats that I have discovered so far. And so we'll look at those together to help you guys navigate through those as you're reading or listening to the story. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me at powersk@msdr9.org, and happy reading, friends.